Eternal Father, I offer you the body and the blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. In atonement for our sins and those of the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and the love, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For our sins and those of the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. A sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world.
I offer you the body and the blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus.
The body in the blood. of a sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body
on us and
Greetings, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, to a celebration of the Eucharist on the second Sunday of Easter, within the octave of Easter. Today, we also celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday. The Mass intentions for the faithful departed, Catherine Raja Dore, Cecilia Lai, Jennifer Tan Gek Lang, Mary Lee Lai King, Bertram Sia, Gladys Sia, Joseph Peter Pereira, Mary Moraes Pereira, John William Pereira, Jane Divika Kaden Pakrisami, Magdalene Lee, All Souls in Purgatory, Clement Philip Jeremiah, Anthony Michael, Lakshmi Teresa, Michael Selvam Murugia. Special intentions, Aidan Polus, intentions of the donor, conversions of sinners, Thomas C, Felicia Ang, Monica Yeo, Paul Thomas, Vincent Yeo, containment of COVID-19 pandemic, Anna Jeremiah, Adrian Francis Sullivan, safety, poor and destitute in the world, all children in orphanages, good health and well-being, elderly in nursing homes, good health and well-being, God's mercy and compassion on the world. And for Thanksgiving, Anna and family, Saint Bernadette.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and the blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son. And on the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion. Have mercy on us and on the whole
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
A very good evening to you, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, as we celebrate today's Eucharist on the second Sunday of Easter, and also called a Divine Mercy Sunday, we celebrate the risen Lord, risen for all of us, risen because He loves us. And let us share that love with one another. But before we share this love of God in this Eucharist, let us turn to God, a God who is forgiving, a God who is compassionate. Together we pray. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Holy and Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The first reading, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The whole community remained faithful to the teaching of the apostles, to the brotherhood, to the breaking of bread, and to the prayers. The many miracles and signs worked through the apostles made a deep impression on everyone. The faithful all lived together and owned everything in common. They sold their goods and possessions and shared out the proceeds among themselves according to what each one needed. They went as a body to the temple every day, but met in their houses for the breaking of bread. They shared their food gladly and generously. They praised God and were looked up by everyone. Day by day, the Lord added to the community those destined to be saved. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The responsorial psalm, the response is, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His love has no end. Let the sons of Israel say, His love has no end. Let the sons of Aaron say, His love has no end. Let those who fear the Lord say, His love has no end. Response, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His love has no end. I was thrust down and falling, but the Lord was my helper. The Lord is my strength and my song. He was my Savior. There are shouts of joy and victory in the tents of the just. Response: give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His love has no end. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord, a marvel in our eyes. This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad. Response: give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His love has no end. The second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in His great mercy has given us a new birth as His sons, by raising Jesus Christ from the dead, so that we have a sure hope and the promise of an inheritance that can never be spoiled or soiled and never fade away, because it is being kept for you in the heavens. Through your faith, God's power will guard you until the salvation which had been prepared is revealed at the end of time. This is a cause of great joy for you, even though you may for a short time have to bear being plagued by all sorts of trials, so that when Jesus Christ is revealed, your faith will have been tested and proved like gold. Only it is more precious than gold, which is corruptible, even though it bears testing by fire. And then you will have praise and glory and honor. You did not see Him, yet you love Him. And still without seeing Him, you are already filled with a joy so glorious that it cannot be described, because you believe, and you are sure of the end to which your faith looks forward. That is the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus said, you believe because you can see me. Happy are those who have not seen and yet believe. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
In the evening of that same day, the first day of the week, the doors were closed in the room where the disciples were for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood among them. He said to them, peace be with you, and showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were filled with joy when they saw the Lord, and he said to them, peace be with you. As the Father sent me, so am I sending you. After saying this, he breathed on them and said, Receive the Holy Spirit. For those whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. For those whose sins you retained, they are retained. Thomas, called the twin, who was one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. When the disciples said, We have seen the Lord, he answered, Unless I see the holes that the nails made in his hands, and can put my finger into the holes they made, and unless I can put my hand into his side, I refuse to believe. 8 days later, the disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. The doors were closed, but Jesus came in and stood among them. Peace be with you, he said. Then he spoke to Thomas. Put your finger here. Look, here are my hands. Give me your hand. Put it into my side. Doubt no longer, but believe. Thomas replied, My Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, You believe because you can see me. Happy are those who have not seen and yet believe. There were many other signs that Jesus worked and the disciples saw, but they are not recorded in this book. These are recorded so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing this, you may have life through his name. And this, my dear friends, is the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One of the most important changes in reform since Vatican II has been the liturgical changes. The priest faces the people. The altar is brought nearer. And the local language is used. It has replaced Latin. And the lay people are more involved. And beneath the host of other liturgical changes is the sign of peace. It is sometimes or most times dismissed as some tiresome liturgical change or duty. There are actually some people who use this time to check on their handphones or to check on something they needed to at that moment. Peace is the first gift of the resurrection. The first words that Jesus uttered when he appeared to his disciples in the upper room in today's gospel, peace be with you. And with this peace, he breathes on them the Holy Spirit. He takes away the fear from them. He takes away the anger from them. And most of all, he wipes away their tears. So it is the same spirit at the beginning of time that went over the waters and brought goodness to the world. God formed the first creature, the first man, from the clay of the earth. Life came only when he breathed into man. In the book of Ezekiel, or rather the prophet Ezekiel, the people had become old boneyards, as they call it. A day when they became dry bones. And they felt God's spirit breathe and bring them life. In Luke's gospel, we see how Elizabeth felt the Holy Spirit as she praised Mary. Oh, highly favored, the Lord is with you. So it is this same Spirit that will send us forth to bring peace to the world. Our masses has all its color, its charm, and its community, what we call coziness. But now, because of this situation, we're all looking at our televisions or at our handphones or our iPads. But all this will become a hollow experience, or rather a hollow ceremony, unless the sign of peace represents a genuine effort of harmony and reconciliation. So the message is clear. If you cannot reach out your hand of friendship to your neighbor, you cannot put out your hand to receive Jesus. And in the midst of all these complications, our brokenness, our broken relationships, our pain, our sorrow, peace allows us to bring Christ, to encounter all these problems that we face. And in this situation, so the resurrection of Jesus holds out an invitation to all of us. Peace be with you. It invites us to let Jesus do what he has done for many of us. It invites us to love again when our love has been rejected and we are tempted to hate. It invites us to hope again when we are in despair. It invites us to pick up the broken pieces of our lives and start all over again in the name of Jesus. So the resurrection is the good news that Jesus has defeated evil and death. It is the good news that nothing can destroy us. Not pain, not sorrow, or even death. Jesus is alive. He is active in our lives, ready to work miracles in our lives, only if we allow him. What is your response? Peace be with you. As a community of peace, let us all together profess that faith that can bring us together as one people of God. Together we pray. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, a light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and Son, who with the Father and Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Casting doubt aside, we praise our Lord and God and humbly ask for the answer to our prayers and those of the whole world.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, stronghold of trust in the everlasting mercy of God, that the gift of faith be generously shared with all who search for it. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who answer the call to a life of civic service, that they may be ever mindful of the sanctity of all life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the wounded, the sorrowing, and the hopeless, that they know God's mercy through the community's love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all assembled here to celebrate Christ's victory, that faith, light of lives, and the lives of those we love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Holy and loving God, you raised your Son from death in the tomb. Hear us and give answer through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices at your hands and for the praise and glory of his name, for the good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts together sing the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And gathered together, my dear friends, formed by divine teaching, we now pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Come, let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but when you say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.